श्रीमते रामानुजाय नमः। सिट ऑडिबल। According to the inescapable rule and framework of the whole cosmos, there are few unavoidabilities, that is the dilapidation of energy, depletion of resources, disease of body or organisms, and finally death or demise of structures in living forms. So these things are unavoidable. And you know that everybody is having, as per the science of hedonics and eudaimonics, everybody is having a feeling that they must be joyous, uninterruptedly joyous by means of a disease, diversification and factors of even departure in the form of death. Naturally, there are few people who are not having the fear of death or fear of disease. Those people can be classified into two extremities, with absolute realization and with absolute nihilism or absolute ignorance. Those who are atrociously vehement, for them they don't bother about the death, they don't bother about destruction, they don't bother about fame, they don't bother about socialization, etc. And those who are in the abstract end of realization of reality, they too also have the same thing, bothering about nothing. So we have a basic feeling that we are afraid of death, we are afraid of old age, we are afraid of diseases, we are afraid of mental imbalance. All of these things are bothering us very much. But death is an one-time activity, and eschatology is a science that deals with what happens after death, which nobody has repatriated from the abode of after-death experience, and they have not come to us and narrated. But that which is cruel than death, that which is a perennial death, death is an instantaneous activity, the continuity of which is unintelligible. But the cruel form of death, the incessant shower of the feeling of death, is insecurity. If a person is insecure, he is dying each and every second. And as somebody told, bravery, self-confidence, and rooting into the supportive factors of proper activity or dynamism, that can give you feeling of security. Feeling of security is different from being secure. Feeling of security is different from being secure. And moreover, if the force that has causated this insecurity, there are also three types. One is the peril, which is in the form of a national ubiquity, a global ubiquity, or which has more permeation. In such serious activities or serious circumstances, the feeling of insecurity is natural, as well as biological, as well as by the psychological implications. The feeling of insecurity on areas where they are beyond our control, where they are magnificent in stage, where they are hyper conspicuous in nature, the feeling of insecurity is natural biologically and psychologically. Wherever they are manageable, there will be an initiative or inceptive insecurity. Then persons who can balance, they can balance themselves, and within few minutes they can just reconfigure themselves to look for the solutions for the problem, not totally getting into the problem of lamentation or solitude or self-exploitation. They will not go for such process. So many petty issues are there for insecurity. So many things on basis of observations and expectations. If something has happened, like robbery or looting that has happened in the neighborhood, naturally that will create some feeling of insecurity with the neighbor people. So there are petty issues or trivial issues, there are conspicuous issues, and there are hyper conspicuous issues. And the thing of bravery must not be just bravery of concept. If a person is really brave, that bravery must blossom into dynamic activity, wherein by the person, sparing no effort, undertakes all the possible measures within his might. So bravery is not a concept, bravery is something which is in practical usage. Bravery is a practical, demonstrative, exemplary implementation style, and it, no doubt, it blossoms from concept. That which blossoms from concept and dies within the mind, that is not bravery, that is blind audacity or impudence as per psychology. So what we want is, real security, not feeling that we are secure or imagining that we are secure and thinking that we are secure and opening the doors and unlocking all of our lockers and allowing all persons in that, it is not the proper way. So it is having the same feeling. If somebody feels that they are secure, there are only three possibilities. The person is very responsible and he is very active, number one. Number two, he is amidst an administration which is good governance, which is a masculine rule. Number three, he has surrendered to God. These are all the only three ways which are available by which a person can feel secure. That he is responsible, he is undertaken, he is being entrusted to a responsible governance, he has surrendered to the ultimate reality who is more responsible, more merciful, hyper-potential, all-embracing and omniscient and omnipotent. These are all the three ways for becoming really secure. And regarding the topic, national security, dream or reality, if you say that dream or reality, as per logics, we have discussed about disjunction. Is it dream or reality? Then immediately there is a problem. You are thinking that dream is different from reality. It is not so. Whatever that is there in your dream is of three types. We cannot think that all dreams are just what we see. There are innumerable types of dreams. All dreams that we see, they are not be totally hastily generalized by the fallacy of hasty generalization or hasty commonalization. We must not bring everything. Number one, a person who thinks about what he has not qualified himself, where he has not been a deservable tool for getting that benefit, that type of thinking, overthinking without any implementation is known as autism. That is known as autism in psychology, number one. Number two, the imprints are reflection of a person's experiences at the time of sleeping state, that is a dream, that is read in hypnology. That is autism, this is read in hypnology. A person who is having zeal, who is having untiring effort, who is having a great dynamic approach towards achieving something, the achievement for which he has been planning about things in his mind, potentializing and preparing himself, that dream is known as dynamism. So there is a dynamic dream, there is an artistic dream, and there is a hypnotic dream. And that type of dream which we mention here is a dynamic dream. That dream should come in reality. So dream comes in reality if the dream is connected with reality. So terrorism is also reality. So anti-terrorism, naturally it should be reality. We are all real. We are real. Truth is real. Peace is real. Harmony is real. If the qualities are real, if the beneficiaries are real, if the intruders are real, why can't be the benefaction or the benefit be real? Naturally it is real. Because as this problem of intrusion, this problem of intrusion, naturally as per the global degradation phenomenon, it is coming down the slope. Coming down the slope, it will be accelerated. Whereas to put it into order for reinstallation, as per the push and pull hypothesis of slope survey and slope up climbing, we have to pull it up. So it is arduous. So reality is arduous, but it is real. So we are talking about the real reality. Number one, what is terrorism? To create an eternal fear inside the minds of people. There are two types of terrorism. The feeling of fear is of two types. Person who has committed a mistake, he will be having a fear for punishment. A person who has created disharmony, he will be having the fear of separation. A person who has made a business mistake or error of handling of wealth and its distribution, in which he has hyper-diversified or mali-diversified his assets, he'll be afraid of his social status, his asset status, as well as repute and conductivity and continuity of his business standard in the society. So the fear that is consequential is not terrorism, that is fear. Somebody asked me, what is the difference between fear and vigilance? Being afraid of something where there is a possibility and also trained to assault on the possibilities of that intrusion, that is vigilance. Being afraid of something where we have to be afraid, and also it ends in action, not in just hallucination or self-consolation, that is vigilance. So being afraid of something to be afraid is vigilance, and being afraid of everything irrationally is known as fear. So we have to make our fear vigilance, we have to make our vigilance into knowledge, we have to make our knowledge into implementation, we have to make our implementation well distributed, we have to make our distribution well integrated. If these things are not happening, then immediately it is a daydream, not even a night dream, this will become a daydream. So it lies in our hands to convert. See, somebody asked me,